So it looks like we're going to come on a fraction early. As we have Anna Maria Popescu, 33 years old, first fenced in the World Championships back in 2002. Has competed in four Olympic Games. Athens, she was 16th. In Beijing, she won the silver medal. Should have won gold, but Britta Heidemann of Germany was on an absolute roll. 11th in London, 9th in the individual in Rio, but won the team gold with Romania in those Olympic Games. She's won two team golds at World Championships as well, back in Paris in 2010, Catania in 2011. She's had her injury problems. She's had a comeback from an injury from last season. So world ranking, only world ranked number 9, but she's worked her way up impressively.
Well, she started the season ranked 41 in the world. And her goal was to get back into the top 16. Well, she's done that in great form this season. And
so they're ready and on guard for the second of these semi-finals. We have another slight technical issue. So here we go for the second of the semi-finals. It is the very experienced Anna Maria Popescu from Romania against Courtney Hurley of the USA.
Well, in terms of experience, the ball is very definitely in Anna Maria Popescu's court. But Courtney Hurley has had a very good day today. She took out Coraline Vitalis in the quarterfinals, Tatiana Andreashina in the 16, and Alexandra Zemikowska in the 32. So not an easy path for her today. But Popescu has taken out world number 2, Krivitska, Lena Krivitska, in the quarterfinals. Joanne Bajura of Ukraine in the 16, and former world champion Rosella Fiamingo in the round of 32. And she has looked like a winner all day today, Anna Maria Popescu. You can tell when she's got her game face on.
Well, first point goes to the American. And you can see Anna Maria Popescu just holding her finger up at the referee and saying, "No, I got caught there. Attacked from slightly too far out, couldn't bring it through." And presented a sitting target to Hurley.
Popescu has pretty much all day maintained a very defensive posture, and it has worked very well for her.
Popescu's so efficient with her blade movements. Does everything for a reason. There's no excessive flailing around. Fencers just taking it cautiously, looking for an opening.
Well, it's early. It's early going here, and they're both going to look at each other closely. Try and figure out what the other is thinking and how they're going to approach the match.
Well,
but it is Hurley who is sort of maintaining that defensive posture.
Well, a little bit of a shrug there from Popescu. That's better.
That's her first solo hit.
Yeah.
Maybe that will. She's not a person you think of as suffering from nerves.
That's hot.
But maybe that will get her started here.
So in Epe, you see quite a lot of feint attacks, don't you? So trying to lure your opposition into a counter-attack.
Well, you're trying to start an action from your opponent that you can counter. And
so it's a second intention. Yeah. So you make a move, but it's not not fully committed. You think your opponent then does something that you can then counter it again. And we're into the break at 3 apiece.
Well, back to level. They've had their exploratory period. And no damage done. And we can see the...
If anything, I think Hurley would be a little bit more disappointed at the break because she had that lead. Just the last 2 points. Popescu seemed to have upped the pace and upped the gear, and she's standing up and she's ready to go.
Her chair is still on her end of the piece, but Anna Maria Popescu came to her end of the piece, took a sip of water, said she didn't want the chair, and is back out at the on guard line, waiting for Courtney Hurley. And I think we're going to see a different Anna Maria Popescu here in the second period.
Yeah, well, she's got the momentum now. There was a definite shift towards the end of that first period. Because both of these fencers left-handers. So any advantage for the left-hander facing the right-hander is gone.
Courtney Hurley is a right-handed fencer.
Yeah, no, I'm talking rubbish.
Popescu is left-handed.
Yeah, so Popescu, in a way, the advantage goes to the left-hander, you've got to say. Been a long day.
It has been. And it's only day one. Nice there from Courtney Hurley. Little beat there. And a nice disengage into the hit. Popescu slightly rash there. She was trying to force that one and it paid the price. Well, Courtney Hurley returns the favor.
Yeah, rash actions don't necessarily pay off in Epe.
Popescu beautifully picks up the blade, turns, gets the hit.
And we're back to 6 apiece. Well, level pegging as we were at the break.
Yeah.
Well, they do say Epe is an experienced weapon. You have to put the time in.
Lovely there from Popescu. Well, you can say that about all the fencing, but you know, in Epe, you know, that is definitely the case. Two years ago, 2015, I think, our world champion was Géza Imre of Hungary, who was 41.
And he went on to win a silver medal at the Olympic Games.
Exactly.
Should have won gold, really, shouldn't he?
Level pegging, seven apiece. Well, both of these fencers have given away points on rash attacks. And so if it's done anything, it's just made them even slightly more cautious. No one wants to give away a lead at this stage. It's different when you just first started the match, the first couple of points, but as we go into the final third, having a lead is so important.
That was lovely from Anna Maria Popescu. And she's gonna surrender that weapon and get another one.
Let's have a look at this.
It's really these end of piece angles from the slow-mo are really difficult to read because we're only seeing, in that case, the receiving end of that hit. We can't really see how she fashioned. That attack.
I imagine Popescu will be slightly more defensive now as they go into the break and they step away.
Still as tight as you can get.
It really is, but I think if anything, then the momentum is slightly more with the experience of Anna Maria Popescu. She has really kind of been around and seen a lot in this sport. She started fencing at age 10, picked up Epe apparently because it was the only left-handed weapon in the club.
Well, that's as good a reason as any. But look, again, Popescu comes down, has a drink of water, has just a couple of words with her coach. She knows what to do, and now she's back out to the on-guard line. And there's still 17 seconds remaining in the second period. She's thinking through all of these things, and Courtney Hurley is getting, I'm sure, some very good advice from her coach. But this is going to be, I think this is going to start off cagey, like we've seen, but at some point somebody's going to try and break it open here. And both of them need to have some patience. So I think, especially if Anna Maria Popescu tries to rush things, she'll pay the price. This lovely block out there from Courtney Hurley.
Draws the scores level. That couldn't be any tighter, could it? Who would you favor going into the business end of this match, David?
You know, looking at it on paper, you would say, well, Anna Maria Popescu. I don't think so. I think they've been very evenly matched here. And Courtney Hurley has just as good a shot at this as world number 9.
Well, a little shake of the head there from Popescu.
Yeah, and she knows that she was rushing it. She knows that she was pushing. And it, you know, that's what we said at the start of this. Whichever one.
Oh, that time Courtney Hurley went in a little bit too rushed to the low line.
Now, better there from Popescu. And this is an interesting, she just very slowly steps in and then, just, I wouldn't call it really a flesh. Technically, it probably is, but it was very tricky.
Courtney Hurley.
Not having any of it.
No, bringing it back level again. So the target score is 15. You see a simultaneous attack there at the end. There's a minute left on the clock.
Able to control the blade, but not do anything with it. Courtney Hurley is a very strong fencer, and I mean physically strong. You're not just gonna, you know, take her blade and move it out of the way without a battle.
Great blade work from the American there again.
All right, now the pressure is on Anna Maria Popescu. There's 29 seconds remaining in the match. She's got to bring it level. But, you know, we know, and we know she knows, that if she presses, she's going to get herself in trouble. And she is now officially in trouble.
Yeah, 2 points may not seem like much, but the American is only 2 points away from the target score. And the American can defend, Hurley can defend, back off to the line, but that time, Popescu able to draw that counter.
She's got to be very careful here.
And just avoided the attack using distance, Popescu, after having pressed Hurley all the way to the back line. Popescu coming home beautifully there. He's leveled it. Well, that was big from the Romanian. When she needed to, she drew on all of her experience.
That was textbook. Anna Maria Popescu. Cool, calm, and collected. Is she going for it? She does. And now there is less than a second remaining on the board. She went for the win. That was a big gamble. That was a huge gamble.
She's not going to go forward now, is she? So
no, but Courtney Hurley
comes running forward.
To.
And that's it. It's over. And Anna Maria Popescu came right from behind at the end. But just when you thought that she'd thrown it away, the experience of the Romanian.
That is an absolute classic Anna Maria Popescu match right there.
Well, that